As I create this fan, I'm reminded that I've never done this before. I mean, I did do a fan years ago on a young Indian girl called Sunshine. And it was a Southern Arapaho girl holding a feathered fan and with a elk tooth dress. I jabbed myself with my X-Acto knife. Anyway, what I'm doing right now is doing the beadwork that will be on her dress. I think I'm gonna put that just a little higher. Thank you. just went outside and to see what all the yakking's about, and it's a couple of good old boys out there drinking beer, enjoying the sunshine, and yakking. And they're still yakking. Good old boys. Anyway. Alright, I think I got the fan where I like it. Well, I think I'm going to go over this with a brush right now. And lighter fluid. I use a lighter fluid to soften the clay. I don't know why it does it. I couldn't tell you in a million years, but something chemical about it that will smooth the clay. Actually melts the clay a little bit. It will be the last thing I do today, because once I put this on, it takes a while for it to evaporate completely. And it won't be workable till probably later on this afternoon. So I'm just going to let this dry completely. I'll come back, take a look at the face, see if there's anything I need to do to improve it or clean it up even more. I'll do the same thing with the fan I just made. I'll put a little more detail into that tomorrow too. I want to go home and take a look at pictures of actual fans that ladies would carry and see if there's anything I can either add or take away to what I've done. Hit the bead work and that will take down the roughness in some areas of the bead work. The battery seems to be giving out on my camera, so it just shut down. It said the battery's low, so I'm going to end my video here. And see you tomorrow. Well, I won't see you tomorrow. I'll see you next week. Good night.